Welcome to the Iowa State Dairy. My name is Gail Carpenter. I'm an assistant teaching professor in the Department of Animal Science, and I'll be taking you on a tour this morning. So we are starting here in the lactating barn. This is where our milking cows live and spend all their days. When they're not being milked, they live out here in the lactating barn. We have our feed alley here where they can come up and eat whenever they want during the day. They're free to express all their natural behaviors. They can come up and eat when they want. And then they have beds to lie on when they're ready to go lie down. So they are here socializing with their friends for most of the day, except for when they are going up to the milking parlor to be milked, which is what you're gonna see later on in this tour. So these black and white cows are called Holstein cows. Holsteins are the most common breed of dairy cow in the United States. They're also the highest producing dairy breed. So our cows here at the Iowa State Dairy, they'll make about 75 or 80 pounds of milk in a day. And all of that gets taken to prairie farms and made into milk, cheese, and yogurt, and ice cream that you can enjoy at home. So at any given time, we have 350 to 400 cows out here in the lactating barn that are being milked. All of the cows that are milked here at the Iowa State Dairy were born and raised here at the Iowa State Dairy. And so the next place that you're gonna go is to our G barn, and Anna's gonna show you how the calves are raised before they end up in the lactating barn.
Hi, I'm Anna Hansen. I'm one of the calf barn workers here. We actually hand feed all of our calves up until they are weaned from milk. So they are about weaned at about 3 months of age, and then they get moved into this building, which is basically a transition building. They get moved a few more times until they get to our lactating barn, which is about 2 years of age when they enter the milking herd. It's really fun to see your calves grow up. And some of my calves are in this barn, so I've got to deal with them, giving them their first milk, feeding them 3 times a day, and then seeing them grow up and get a lot bigger where you can't really pick them up anymore. So next we're gonna go over to Brianna in the feed center and learn more about that area.
My name is Brianna McBride, and I'm a senior in dairy science and food science, and we are in the feed center at the Iowa State Dairy. Behind me is our corn silage pit, and this is locally grown corn silage just right around Iowa State, and so all these cows get fed local food. Just as athletes have dietitians, all of our cows have nutritionists that come and formulate their diets specific for their needs every single day. As a feeder at the Iowa State Dairy, we start our shifts here on 4 a.m. and we combine different ingredients to feed to the cows in the morning, and they get fed so that way they can have their direct nutrition every day. That can be anything from hay to straw to our corn silage, and we also have different minerals that we give them to meet all of their nutrient requirements.
I'm Josh Peek. I'm the dairy manager here at the Iowa State University Dairy Farm, and right now we're in the milking parlor. So what happens here, cows come in here twice a day, every day, and this is where we harvest the milk from them. We can harvest milk from 12 cows on each side, so 24 total in the barn at a time. So right now we're milking 380 cows. The barn has a capacity of about 460. Right now we produce between 75 and 80 pounds per cow per day. We clean the udders off, we make sure that they're completely disinfected, test the milk, make sure that it's all of good quality, and then we hook the milking machines up to it. The milking machine is hooked up to a vacuum, which is downstairs. When we turn it on, the vacuum starts coming through what's called the milking claw. And so what it's doing is just providing a little bit of vacuum pressure in a pulsating motion, just like you would with your hands. And then we put it on there, and so it really, the machine is milking it just like you would with your hands, but just adding a little vacuum to come in. And so the milk from here is chilled down to 40 degrees within the first 10, 15 minutes or so, and then put into the tank where it's held until it gets shipped to the processor. When the machines come off and the cow's done milking, we go back through, double check, make sure the machines did their job well, and then we'll do what's called a post-dip and kind of make sure that they're still clean and ready to go back out to the barn. So we've got a couple full-time milkers, but we employ a lot of students out here, between either them being employees milking the cows, or we also have a lot of classes that come out here, and so we can teach students how to do it.
So this is our bulk tank room. This is where we store milk here at the dairy. So after the cows are milked, the milk will go through all of these pipes and be stored in both of these tanks. This tank holds 52,000 pounds of milk, and this other one holds 35,000 pounds of milk. So it's a lot of milk, and our milk here gets picked up every other day to go to prairie farms to make other dairy products. The milk is kept in these tanks to be kept cool, so that way it is a fresh product when it's picked up. It doesn't go bad, and we keep it at very strict temperature regulations to make sure that the milk is the freshest and at the best quality it can be when it gets to the grocery store and eventually to your counter.
Well, thank you for joining us today. I hope you enjoyed this tour of the Iowa State Dairy. If you want to come visit us in person, feel free to call. We do tours for student groups and schools, and we also have a family day at the Iowa State Dairy in June.